Jebe, what is your view on the Buddhist theory of no soul? And how logical is it that we don't have a soul?
Yeah, okay. I'll show you the depth of Hindu teaching as well as hopefully the depth of, I'm not a Buddhist, but I have real love for Buddha and what he stands for. I'll try and show you the reconciliation of this deeper vision of Buddhism as well as the deeper vision of Hinduism and show you how they are closely linked, even though they appear like the vocabulary is quite opposite to each other. Let me show you. You see, what Buddha said is this. See how powerful it is. He said, really, when you say, this is me, I, ego, it is nothing but a flux. There is no such individual. It is, if you like, a flux. Like the lovely example Buddha gave is this. You come to a river, the river is flowing. Now every moment, every bit of the water has moved on and new water is coming in. So it's not the same river any moment. And yet you say, oh, river. It's a flux, shoom, moving. And yet you give it if you like, a compartmentalizing and say, this is a river. You give it an identity. It's a flux. The same way saying Buddha, this ego that you are so fixed on, this me, it's just a flux. When you recognize that what you are so fixated on, your ego, is just a flux, you can rise above this flux. And you see, the reason why he was so kind of against the idea of even the word soul is simply this. He's soul, by soul, he was really attacking the idea of ego. But the Buddhist would say, no, he was actually attacking the idea of Atman. Not really. Because the way we define Atman, Atman is not an individual, it's not a soul, it's not ego. It is something beyond body, mind, intellect, and the ego. So we are talking about rising above the idea we are the ego in the Hindu tradition. This is the deeper vision of Hinduism, rising above the idea you are the ego. You are something more than the ego, not the body, the mind, the ego. So how different is it from the idea of Buddhism saying rise above the idea of the I-ness that you feel is really a flux. Rise above it. So the deeper level, they meet up extremely well. But we are claiming, this is from me and my mentor Vivekananda, Buddha was not here to undermine Hinduism. He was deliberately attacking the idea of ego, but in order for him to do, he had to attack the idea of soul. Because when you say soul, that means it's ego. And that idea here to demolish. And that is why he was saying, you use the word anatman. Atman itself is without, is no different from the way Buddhism defines as our enlightened state. No different.